everybody, welcome to the Kirsty Meekins Show. Today, we are going to do a soak-off on the fabulous Faye, or Fussy Faye as we know her as. How long have you had these nails on for? Oh God, she's going to give me the dates. She's had them on a while. We'll crack on with it. Please stay with us because it's going to be a journey and we're going to reveal the state of Faye's nails because she has got a poolie. So keep watching.
July 21st.
That's when they were first done?
No, that's when they were last done. That's how long the same fillers.
Oh my God.
Yeah, exactly. Can you hear this, everybody? She's abandoned me.
Neglected
me. Disowned me.
Well, I've been on holiday and I've had COVID.
That's no excuse.
And we've launched our own job.
Six weeks.
RIP headphone users.
Yeah. So you can see underneath here, we've got some serious length under there.
It's gross.
You don't like it, do you?
Get them off.
You're not a fan. This one is broke. While I was on holiday, Faye had a boo-boo.
I did.
So she went to another nail technician who... Yeah,
I know. What?
I know.
Why didn't you ring me? I'd have sorted your...
So she went to another nail technician who fixed it for her.
She did.
She did quite a good job, I think.
She did an amazing little job.
Yeah.
It's only been glued on once and it's been off about 3 weeks.
So it's done while that is.
It's broken off at the wedding.
Broke off at the wedding.
At the wedding.
You were screwing, weren't you?
Yeah, but I wasn't bridesmaid at that one.
So you're not as screwing, but you were still screwing.
Yeah.
Screwing.
I was bridesmaid
screwing
the week after.
For those other people that don't know what that means like you were mad.
Yeah.
Right, I thought you would mean you were screwing.
Spewing.
Yeah.
Why were you fuming?
The nail was broken off. Are you joking? It looks like I've had my finger off.
I'm just getting really confused.
No, she was mad.
Right.
That the nail broke off.
It came off because she was mad.
No.
Do you think she's like the Incredible Hulk when she gets mad?
Well, just breaks off a nail off.
But let's take off these stones. So you're going to use an old pair of nippers just to get those off. And to be fair, you don't need to do the full length because we're going to cut this length away. I'm going to use my Navy Tools nail cutters. So because this is a poolie, you know, it's a poorly nail, it's a sad tragedy happened
to it. It is a tragedy.
It is, yeah.
Don't play it down. I'm furious.
I'm not. You think I'm... taking the Mickey,
yeah, I do. The
you?
Michael, yeah, I do.
Yeah, but I'm not yeah, being sarcastic
yes,
at all.
Yes, you are. Full of empathy. Full of.
I'm not.
I nearly said enthusiasm.
I would leave them on if you doesn't shut up.
Yeah. So we're going to cut the lengths off. But what I want to do is cut them.
Not too low. I need to tell you that first.
I know that. Okay. I know.
Shut your eyes when you do it in case it.
So I'm going to cut them where the nail finishes, yeah? Right, let's get these cut off and then I can take the stones off. Because the thing is, don't get like thinking, oh my God, I need to take all the stones off the full length of the nail while you're cutting.
I don't know why I'm gritting my teeth, but you're making me grit my teeth.
Yeah, so we don't need to take the stones off the entire length. Can I have your hand, please?
Yes, sorry.
We just need to take it off. What's left. And I know you're probably thinking, well, you're soaking them anyway, so why are you taking them off? There is no way that the acetone is going to penetrate through that top coat because top coats generally are non-porous. So it won't accept the acetone into it to break it down. So we've got the Nail Chemy dust extractor. Whack that on. I'm going to use our debulking bit. So it's super serrated. The further up the barrel you go, the more coarse it is. Further down, the less coarse. That's because we've got shorter teeth on there. Not like my teeth. And I'm using the mini toy nail drill from E-Nail Couture. I'm going to put it on 15. And I'm going to start by removing that gel polish. You're not going to touch the natural nail. So not only is it removing the gel polish, it's also removing some of the acrylic that's underneath.
My hand's wearing foldy. I'll put it there.
No, I wasn't saying you put it there. Just, I was trying to get move you in it. I couldn't move
it. That's right on.
So you can see that these have been filled. And you can see the previous glitter here.
You thought it was a greenie.
But at least you can see that now. Yeah. Quite a nice glitter. I do like it. So I'm going to remove 80% of the acrylic with the debulk bit. This is going to really help with soaking them off. Some people just take off the gel polish and then start to soak, but it actually takes a lot longer to soak off then. You kind of want to remove at least sort of 70 to 80% of the acrylic. And if you look at the end of this nail, you can see that we're reducing that thickness down. See, whereas you look at the... They're a bit dusty, aren't they? Look at the end of those. So you can see the thickness is there. So that's what we're reducing it down to, this kind of thickness. I'm gonna go a little bit lower. Want to make sure you don't hit the natural nail. Be very gentle when you come close to making contact.
Skip it round.
Yeah. Get rid of that glitter. And I'm going very light now. I'm kind of feathering over the top. I'm not putting a lot of pressure on. So as soon as you start to see the natural nail coming through, that's your indication that you're going to stop. So I'm going to use now, because we need to abrase this. You can go over with a normal file. You can go over like with a 180 grit file if you want to, but you can go over, and this just makes everything nice and clean, with our brand new... Oh, the gloss sticker on, I can't open it.
Wait a sec, when she can open the box. It's a bit like one of them where it's like a fake.
So these are our brand new sanding bands. They are made from ceramic particles, so they have far less heat. So with a normal sanding band, you know that they can heat up quite quick. That's one of the reasons that they're used on a slow mode, and obviously they're used on a slow speed as well, because you don't want to eat into the natural nail. But we're going to use the medium sanding bands.
So do you have different grits?
Yeah, we've got medium and fine.
No,
good job you asked. Well, I'm not being sarcastic because some people will be like, they're medium, what are the other ones?
Right.
And the medium and fine, not medium in size, it's the grit. These are a 150 grit. So,
it's a literal like a mini file.
Yeah. And the purple. They are just absolutely gorgeous, aren't they?
Gorgeous.
I'm going to put them onto our mandrel bit, which has a safety lock system, which is here. It creates tension holding the sanding band in place. Lock that in place like that, look. Nice and secure. I'm going to put this, I'm not going to go no higher than 5 on here. If you don't have an electric file, you can use a 180 or 150 file. But what this does is it creates sort of little etches into the surface of the acrylic, and it makes the acetone penetrate quicker and more efficiently.
And all the hard work going like that.
Oh God, yeah, because
you must take a lot of that out. Abby.
Yeah, that's why I use an electric file, because doing a lot of nails, especially if you work in a salon, you know, it's really, it creates a lot of stress on your wrists and your hands. A lot of people get, you know, repetitive strain injury from using a file so much, whereas you just don't have that with an electric file.
Adam, I think I am going to have a blanket on. Have you seen the colour?
Your hands are freezing.
Ridiculous.
And you'll see when I sort of rotate over, I'll use the front end of the sanding band, but then when I pull over the entire nail, I will use the full length of that sanding band. And this doesn't take long, and I know some people think, well, is it even worth doing that step? Don't skip this step, it's so beneficial, because when the actual acetone is sat on top of the acrylic, it will definitely help speed up that process. So doing this for, what, a minute or two will be well worth it. So if you look at the sanding band now, that can go straight in the bin. You haven't got to clean it or anything like that. Somebody did say, because they are made from ceramic particles, does that make them sanitizable? No, because they're still on a denim band.
Right.
So if I try and take these a bit apart to show you, here we are. You can see that it has a denim center.
Wow.
And that is porous, so there's no way you would clean.
So it's absorbed liquid, presumably.
Yeah, it absorbs germs.
Yeah.
As well.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, if you're the kind of salon that saves, that has all the files per client, so some people have like a bag per client with all their nail files in, and they use them only on that client. Yeah. You could do that. You could save it like that. But for how much they are, they work out at 0.069 pence per band.
0.06
pence. Yeah, but it's 0.069 pence.
Good 6 pence.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, nearly 7 pence.
Nearly 7 pence per band. Why would you even want to save that?
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's so inexpensive.
And I know people might think it's wasteful, but
it's hygienic.
Yeah.
So I'm going to use some foil. This is my big roll of hairdressing foil that I love because it's so thick.
That's amazing.
So I'm going to pull off.
Oh, you need one of them cutters.
Do you know what? I do, because they have them in the salon.
I'm just going to say, yeah, I only know because when I see the girls doing foils in the salon,
I need one of them.
It's like a little guillotine, but foil.
Yeah, I need one of them. How many have I done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's one on. And I'm going to use cotton wool because I just feel like cotton wool really holds the liquid so much better than a lint-free pad. It just holds more liquid and you just get a better soak off with cotton wool. So I've got some acetone in a little dish and I'm going to rip off my pieces of cotton wool. Dimp them in.
It's a new one.
Yeah, dip them in. Cover the nail. Grab the foil.
You need to be generous with it, because don't be scrimping with your acetone.
I won't.
Not you.
Are you coaching people? Sorry.
Yeah, I'm coaching people. Yeah.
Sorry.
I am.
Didn't realise.
Yeah,
because
it's like, oh, well, don't you worry. I'll make sure I'm like, no, not you.
Right, so we're going to do this on all the nails. Right, so we're going to leave them for 10 minutes. We're going to come back to them and see what they are like. The thumb is always the most difficult because it never wants soak off. It always wants to just, you know, really grab on. Right, so we're going to undo the little parcel. Let's have a look. Oh, it's looking quite good. I'm going to use a cuticle pusher to drag off.
God, I think you've been a little slightly.
What? Slightly what?
You said, oh, it don't normally scrape, it don't normally come off.
Hey, with the thumb, it doesn't really like to come off.
Well, I think it's doing. Oh my God, have you seen that smile line?
I know.
Ridiculous.
I think that's so nice.
Get it off.
I don't like that little bit there. That's doing me.
Get it off.
Just cut that bit off there.
That ain't my nail.
It was just probably a tiny bit. I'm pretty pleased with that, to be fair. I am pretty pleased with that.
Well, so you should be. I think that's good.
Yeah, I think, I don't think we need to soak it again. I thought we would need to, I really did.
Brilliant.
Don't let me down now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now this is the poolie. Oh, we just, are you ready to say goodbye?
It'll fall off in a minute. Oh, bye, Felicia.
Bye.
Hey, it's grown back a little bit. I mean, it was a good 3 weeks ago since it was bashed off. I say three. Three, was it three? Is it three, nearly four? Maybe.
Ooh. This might not come off in one. This might need another soaky. Support that nail. So that length there.
Yeah, because look how... Oh no, horrible.
Yeah, we still need to soak that end a bit.
I thought it was getting cut off anyway.
There's still a little... No, not convinced. So I'm just going to go over the file. This is a 180 grit file. Don't need to be harsh. And then we can re-soak this. I'm going to put a little bit of oil on the ones that are completely off. So I'm going to use this NAF Pro.
I'm taking Passion, that with me.
No, you're not. Passion Future Cuticle Oil that I got sent in the post the other day, which is
okay,
really nice.
Okay, well, as Faye loves cuticle oil so much, please feel free to send another liquor bottle for Faye.
Thanks. Thanks
to when she only gets one, she won't let me have each.
I bet you, if you got a PO box, Faye, right, you'd get loads of stuff sent.
Oh,
away.
I'd love
I'm
that.
I'm not saying all of it would be nice.
Yeah.
But
oh, God, Adam, oh my God.
This is the poolie.
Now
this is the
poolie.
Proper poolie. We have like a full-on onycholitis going on here. And she's like got even, she's got like a little hole in
all the years, just be careful. In all the years I've had my nails done, this has only ever happened twice.
Yeah, so it's pretty good.
Just be careful because I know you're going a bit rogue on it and I need you to be careful with it.
So look, that's acrylic.
Oh my God, that's gross.
Yeah. Extra careful.
Can I look?
But what is it? Do you know what? It's growing out
now. Oh my God, that is me. That's my skin underneath.
That's your nail bed.
The nail has come off.
Yeah, we knew that anyway. But
there was a tiny hole in it last time.
No, there wasn't.
It was that
disastrous.
Yes.
Give me tea. I need to file.
It's making me feel queasy.
So it's growing out really nice. It's nearly at the free edge, which is
great. But you
know
how I ended up with that, though, don't you?
Tell me how you ended up with this.
Well, can you remember me banging it?
How did you bang it?
I banged it, and how I didn't lose me extension, my nail extension.
Is it the car door you said?
I can't remember what I did, but I mean, it's weeks and
I
weeks and weeks ago now.
What are you talking about? With telling me that it's...
But I proper banged it, and I mean proper banged it. Just be careful, because that sensation's weird.
Right, let's put a bit of oil on.
Oh, look how poorly. Oh my God, there's a hole.
You know what? I'm quite pleased that it's grown down so far, though, because this was right here.
And my nail doesn't.
It was right there. And I did say to Faye, you know, you really shouldn't be having a nail extension on that nail. And you can imagine what the reaction was. She insisted on having one. And I was like, well, on your head be it. If you lose your thumb, it's not my problem.
Oh my God, I'm not going to use my thumb, am I?
No!
Surely I must be over the worst.
Yeah, you're well over the worst. Because look, it's nearly at the free edge.
You said that when it was right down the end of the...
Nearly
over the worst!
Right, so we're going to clean my board. So this is the metal part of the nail file, which is reusable. And then we've got the disposable file that goes on top of that. I'm going to clean it with the Navy hygiene system. So this is step one, which is here, which is your detergent, which basically cleans it. And then the other Y that disinfects. And then we're gonna put this on, peel off, line it up, drop it on. Take off the sharp edges. Right, so what I'm going to do is take down the length of Faye's nails, because I'll let you into a little secret. Faye is not having a full set of nails on after this soak-off. She's having gel polish on her natural nails, short nails.
Hang on, let me get the mop out, because there's like a pool of tears on the floor.
I know, like, what is that all about? And that's,
it's self-inflicted.
Oh yeah, it's not my choice. It's not my choice. This is Faye's choice.
She's not ditching me as a nail model.
No.
Well, at least I don't think she is.
No. Faye is she's going skiing, duck. She's going skiing. And she thinks that going skiing is having those nails that long. Although she does, you know, protest that she can do anything with those nails on.
I can't.
She does. It's the limit. The skiing is crossing the line, yeah. Isn't it? So she's having short gel polish nails for her skiing little thing that she's doing. However, we have a video proving that you can ski while you've got long nails on, because we did it many years ago, didn't we, Adam?
Yeah, well, you did it.
Yeah, you filmed it, I did it. So, yeah, you know I mean, that was many years ago. I wasn't very good at skiing then. I'm a lot better now. I say I'm a lot better now, I'm skiing for a long time, but you know.
Was that the last time you went skiing?
No, no, because me and Annette, you ski all the time, didn't we? You ski.
Every, oh, was this in the Olympics?
Every, of course.
In the Olympics. Annette in our Winter Olympics.
In the Winter Olympics.
So she does
Olympics,
gymnastics,
yeah,
during the Summer Olympics, and she's a skier, exactly, during the Winter Olympics.
Exactly, yeah.
Did you know about that, Annette an Olympian?
You're Annette.
Yeah.
No, she's not.
Back in the day.
No way.
Gymnastic Olympian.
Was she?
Adam just made up this whole lie. And now it's carried on.
It's lived on.
It's lived on forever.
If you hadn't said anything, I'd have believed you so.
Well, next time you see her, just say, "Are you sure you got me?"
So, is this the length you want?
And that's too long.
No, it's not. Stop being ridiculous. That is not too long. What? How is that too long? I don't get this. Who is this person?
No,
who
but
is this
I don't
woman?
Like natural nails. That's the problem.
Yeah. I think that's perfect.
God, Abe says so himself.
That's the perfect length for you, for this thing.
Yeah.
This skiing little
thing. I can cope with
that. That
I can't
doing.
Cope with the others that long.
So, yeah, people love nails this long, and Faye is...
Yeah. I'm absolutely hating them.
We're chopping them off.
Just watch me appendiciums.
I'm not going to cut your appendiciums.
Not on purpose, anyway.
Debatable. I can't believe I'm cutting like all this gorgeous nail.
Gorgeous. Away. Get it, go. That's too long.
I know, I've got to file it, yeah. For God's sakes, I've got to file it.
God.
Isn't it, we'd say, she turned into a dolphin then. You want to hear how he takes her off when we're on FaceTime? Yeah. I think he just shuts off. The other week, though, he did tell us, didn't he? He was
right,
like,
get out the room.
Yeah, he was like, will you just go upstairs? Come cope with us. And we talked dead quick. And we're almost finishing each other's sentences off.
Yeah.
I went to be my dad's next line. Was it Sunday morning? I think it might be Sunday morning, and I was, like, tired.
Yeah.
I think it was Sunday afternoon, in fact. And
sorry, Adam, I wasn't even paying attention to what you were saying now, because I was watching
it. Hayley and my dad were all talking at the same time, separate things. And I just couldn't cope. And I put my hands over my ears and I just went,
like a child.
Yeah, I literally could not cope. And they were like, what are you doing? And I was like, you're all just too loud. It's just too much. I was like, I just can't cope today. I don't know why.
I want it like that. Not like that. Nick, come down. Stop having them the length you want them and start making them the length I want them. Okay?
Anybody want a nail model? We're going to do cuticle prep now. This is Faye's favourite part.
Yes,
isn't it? So we're going to use the two cuticle prep bits. So we're going in with the cuticle bit first. And what I am going to do is, because we're doing a soak off, because we've done a soak off, I am going to put a little bit of oil on cuticles because it will be easier to do this cuticle prep.
What with the malacca, a little bit
A little bit of something. It's like it'll moisturise them, but it'll also create a very slight barrier, so it should in theory stop me from cutting you. So I'm going to reverse, so it's rotating away from the natural nail, keeping it quite flat, but pushing away the cuticle. Now you don't have to physically push. You'll have a very slight bit of pressure, but the rotation of the bit pushing away from the natural nail,
doctors,
will actually push that nail, push that cuticle away. So I'm going to come round and do this on all of the nails. And I can feel here, it's slightly rubbery. And I can see here we have a bit of stubborn cuticle. So I'm just going to work on that. But I don't want to press too hard because I don't want to eat in the natural nail, and I also don't want to create too much heat. So I'm gently going to tease that back, pushing it back, and it'll also get rid of any of that non-living tissue. So I'm going to use the proximal fold bit now. So with this, again, I want to push away. Just going to turn that down to 3. And we're going to use this to remove any non-living tissue on that cuticle area. I'm going to keep that cuticle push back.
This is your favourite bit there?
Yeah, I love this. Love it.
Do you feel like it's therapeutic or like?
It's just the satisfaction of not having all that scuzz around your nail.
All that what?
Scuzz.
You mean your scuzzy?
Round your cuticle.
All that non-living tissue.
Yeah, gross. I think it's rank.
So this is what we're left with. Short nails. More oil.
Have you been very sparing with the nail?
With the nail?
With the oil. Be more generous.
Look how far that goes. It's actually quite a thick oil. So.
I know, I'll be taking it home with me.
If you want to see, you're not taking it home with you. If you want to see what Faye's nails look like.
I'd love to see my old collection at home.
That are not long, big massive long nails. If you are a short nail lover, then keep watching because that video is going to go live very shortly, I'm sure. So yeah, so if you want to see how they turn out, please check out the Faye video. Faye getting a short nail done. I mean, I'm quite traumatised by it myself. Can I just have a look at them again and show everybody?
So they do look beautiful, actually.
So everybody says what a Faye's nail's like. Well, that's what they like.
That is what they like.
Yeah,
you look lovely there, you do.
But you're still freezing cold.
I know I am.
Why are you so cold?
You're so warm.
You're like blue.
You are so, so warm.
I feel nice.
She's got a cold on, but now on her legs. That's probably...
I know, because I've got my cycling shorts on. I wanted something comfy on, that's why. And I'm fed up putting jeans and leggings on.
Yeah, very nice, apart from your freezing cold. So there you are, guys. Check us out in our next video. Don't forget, everything I've used today will be listed below with all the links and all the discount codes and all that shebang. And please check us out on Facebook and Instagram and TikTok. And I'll see you in the next video. Ta-da, duck!